to you guys about the Kalamazoo River oil spill. Kathy Jessup wrote on July 27, 2010, "The Kalamazoo County's Morrow Dam has become ground zero for containing what officials are calling one of the largest oil spills in Midwest history. Since July 2010, many efforts of the cleanup in Kalamazoo River have occurred. Not only did my research show how the oil spill occurred, but it also shows the efforts of the cleanup and further prevention for other oil spills. The oil spill happened in the Kalamazoo River on July 26, 2010. An estimated 840,000 gallons of crude oil spewed from a ruptured distribution pipeline near Marshall and into the Kalamazoo River. In comparison, the BP oil spill in the Gulf was about 205.8 million gallons. Scott Corbin of Allegan County Emergency Management Director said in Kathy Jessup's article, "If we haven't stopped it by the time it gets to Saugatuck, shame on us." Although there is a devastation through the oil spill, the cleanup will still continue so that the river can return to its natural state. Oil stains will likely ring tree trunks in areas where oiled water crept into flood plains and other upland areas, said Chris Killian on MLive.com. It will take until the year 2015 to have the river back to its natural state. Even after all the cleanup, the government and the people are still trying to prevent this from happening again. Environmental groups are urging U.S. Representative Fred Upton to provide greater oil pipeline oversight, said Chris Killian in a 2011 article. They said that it ended up totaling to more than 1 million gallons of crude oil, so more than they actually had estimated. "We want to shine a light on the spill so that we don't forget what happened," said Cindy Rapper, the state director. The state director of Michigan Clean Water Action. The new program would increase the maximum civil penalties from $100,000 to $250,000 per day. Animals were also affected and are starting to be released back into their natural environment. 2,400 turtles were released with a 96% survival rate. 42 of them had hatchlings that were born at the Wildlife Rehabilitation Center and will be released in the fall of 2011. 3,200 kinds of species have been returned to the wild, including fish, turtles, mammals, and birds. Even after the year of the cleanup, it still continues. This has changed many lives, animals, and Mother Nature as well. Today I discuss the Kalamazoo oil spill, the cleanup, and the prevention. The oil spill occurred almost a year ago, and it'll still take a lot more time to clean up. And if you want to help, contact Hands On Battle Creek. Thank you.